you very much.
First and foremost, heartiest congratulations to all the MTC members for having the 35th anniversary. So please give yourself a round of applause. It's never easy, because I know MUCM is finishing its 9th year and how much effort it takes. So 35 years, I can hardly imagine what you have gone through, ups and downs. Secondly, it's a privilege, and thank you for inviting me to talk in this momentous occasion. Thank you very much. Now, before I begin, follow to lead. I want to ask you one question. Can you tell me how many of you believe that in a team, there are two types of people? One, the follower type. Two, the leader's type. Can I see some hands? Okay, I see some hands. Great. 320 BC. That's quite some time back. A person called Aristotle, who was a Greek philosopher teacher. If we talk about today's term, we'll say he was a coach, trainer, speaker, teacher, all those things. He said, if you're not a good follower, you cannot be a good leader. So now, why am I talking about something? As our Toastmaster Tirath mentioned, I can't count that much, but I'll do it for you. It's 2,300 years. Why am I quoting that for now? That's a pretty old time he has quoted that. So, let me tell you the story why. Now, I want to tell you the 2008, 22nd November, not December, 22nd November, Shamini, I and our family landed in Malacca. I came to join Manipal. And Malacca was declared the UNESCO Heritage City. No, I don't have anything to do with it. But it just coincided that we came and it was declared. I was initially a 90% clinician, 10% academician. When I came to Malacca Manipal, that time it was called Malacca Manipal, now it's Manipal University, I became 70% academician and 30% clinician. A major shift. And I wasn't sure how to deal with that. I went into my office. Office was shared by two people. And my colleague, he was a senior person. He's retired from General Hospital. He was a consultant there. He went to Australia, had some stint there, came back to join as a professor. And I joined as an assistant professor that time. He was initially, he looked pretty grumpy types. He would not talk much. And he had that Australian way, no worries, man. That kind of accent, even though he's Indian. Slowly, but surely, we started to have conversation. And after that, I realized he's not so bad as I thought initially. Not so grumpy. He just needed some time to open up. 2009, early 2009, he told me, so, I'm doing this ultrasound workshop. Would you like to help me in organizing it? And I'm a person who really don't say no very fast. So I said, yeah. I said, okay, you have to do the registration part. I said, what do I have to do? Just write in the Excel file the names. That time there was no Google form. I didn't know Google form at all. Write in the names in the Excel, take a printout, and during the workshop, we'll just take the signatures of the usual registration job. So, okay, done. Another few months later, okay, we are going to do this operative procedure called colposcopic workshop. We are getting the speaker from a trainer from Singapore. Like, okay, you want to help? Yes, because I was learning. Said, okay, this time, can you make flyer? I said, I can make only PPT type flyer. Doesn't matter, make a PPT type flyer. So now my job, registration, plus flyer. And slowly, I realized that he kept giving me one plus one. Okay, now you do marketing. Now you check on the logistics, the trainers coming, just check on the hotel. Now this went on till 2014. 2014, our college opened a committee, a postgraduate committee, and he was the lead. So, do you want to be the secretariat? I need really a lot of help here. I was like, sure. I said, sure, I'll go for it, because I usually don't say no. That doesn't mean that you'll call me for every time roll takers and all. Then the committee was opened. He was like doing a lot of courses. We got people from UK and we got people from India to conduct the courses, preparatory courses, mainly medical related. And I was, every course was different and I was picking up, was learning from them. Then came 2017. He said, I'm going back to Australia. He was Australian PR. And my daughter's finished, my youngest daughter finished her dentistry, everything like now. So I'm done here in Malaysia. Now I've decided to relocate to Australia. I'll be settling down there and bye-bye. Postgraduate committee. And this time I was a bit worried. Because whatever said and done, I had him in front of me. Now, when we organize these courses, these are not like Toastmasters. This comes with a business plan. That means you have to get the number. If you don't get number, you go in a loss. You have to answer. And any corporate group would not like a negative number. They would always want a positive number. That added, okay, now I've been doing flyer, registration, logistic, trainer. By these seven and a half years, I have gained a lot of experience. I have seen him how he deals with that. Not that all his dealings were great. He had his flaws. But I picked up his positive traits. And those three positive traits I'm going to talk about. Because whenever you see a leader you're following, you should know how to filter the positive aspects from the not so positive aspects. Let's not talk about negative. So when I took that, I took with a lot of stress because I need those numbers. But I need those strategies, what I saw him do. 2017, organized the first course, we got the numbers. 2018, organized three more courses. This time our people from Dubai, like, yeah, confidence building up. 2019, I went to Sri Lanka for an education fair. I connected with another faculty there. I said, come, we have a lot of Sri Lankan students, come, let's do a course here. And that person came for a 3-day workshop. Everything was like, whew. And then 2020 happened. Slam. Slam. Gone. And we don't know, first of all, we're all scared. MCO, RMCO, we learned a lot of alphabets and abbreviations that time. I tried online courses. Thanks to Toastmaster, we got used to Zoom, a lot of Zoom training. So we became PhD in Zoom. But not as emphatic. Then 2022, we said, okay, let's try, now it's RMCO, people can come in. Let's try some face-to-face. Let's go for it. Even though with the mask, let's try. We tried. We didn't get enough publicity. 2023, we tried, we got 50% of the number, I had to cancel the course. Then finally, January 2024, we reignited and got back the course again. And total change of strategies. So 2024, this year, June, I was given a new designation called Director of Center for Professional Advancements. It's definitely an accolade for me. Thank you. You see, this first 7-8 years, I was in the shadow of a brilliant guy who had a lot of good points. Of course, he had a lot of not so good points as well. And from that, I learned three things. One, when you're following You build up yourself. It's not you're someone's slave. You're someone's like, you know, you're dominated by someone. No, you learn. You build up yourself professionally, personally. You're not going to be like just sitting, okay, do mechanically, as we say in our medical terms, do spinally. That means don't use the brain, just spinal reaction. No, learn, see what you're doing. So when you're following, if you're not learning, then that following is totally wasted. So first, build yourself. Not only just with the knowledge, but also with the emotional aspect. So that when you're left alone, you can handle it. Two, team. Your team is everything. You have a team, you need to protect it. You need to make sure that you need to have a very good emotional connection with your teammates. For example, this person that I'm talking about, he was very, very protective. It was like, you mess with my team, you mess with me. Like that time. So similarly, I followed that in a different position. I was the student council advisor for 12 years in the college. And that time, I used to put the president of the club, the student council in front. And being the advisor, I used to be either behind him or beside him, never in front of him. So if anything goes wrong, I'll come beside him and say, okay, we need to sort out these things. We, not you. And when something good happens, okay, you can go and enjoy your accolades. So that is what I learned, team. Give the credits where it's due. Third, kindness. Kindness and empathy. These are extremely important words, not just words. These are extremely important traits that a leader must have. And the most important example would be the 2019-2020 Toastmaster term, also known as the pandemic term. We started with so much of hopes, plans, everything got dashed. Then people were like, no, we don't have money, so how can you expect us to pay for Toastmasters? Emotions were varying from going down to anger, irritability, like why should we pay for Toastmasters? We are like, you know, we are not even able to a job, I got retrenched, salary is taking a 20% cut, Toastmasters is not a priority. At that point of time, you need to step back and empathize, show some kindness. But that term, even though we had so many plans, Chamni was one of the area directors also when I was division director. Ultimately, we did not lose a club, and that was the success. Because at least we have all the clubs, we did not lose a club. So for me, that's much more than president distinguished club or district or area or division. So they say, when I say they say, I mean John Maxwell. A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. But when you're a follower, you're learning the ways. So to know the way, you need to learn the way. So that's what you want to do. So that when you become a leader, you need to know the way, go the way, and show the way to your followers. Now that's what I said, three things, BTK. Build yourself professionally, personally. Make sure your team is there together. And K, show some kindness. The BTK, I will also show gratitude to all of you for calling me BTK. Banyak terima kasih.